Hi guys, Chuffy here again. What you see before you is a Lucius Dreadnought pattern drop pod. This one I picked up off Templar Crusader 01, and there'll be a link to his channel and the video where he built this down below. And yes, Temps, it's green! You gotta love the green. I stripped it down in certain places. And I've worked on it quite quickly as well. I only bought this off him yesterday. Yeah, he's done a good job on the build. These drop pods have a weakness in hinge. It's quite well known. And I think he had troubles with one of them. Where is it? One here. Literally, because these doors are solid resin, they're really heavy, so as you pull them down they put a lot of strain on these points, so lots of people have the same trouble. I've fixed it up. Basically I used a piece of plastic card which I've glued in, and to stop it from putting too much glue in, I put a dot in, just soaked a little bit of it up with a piece of tissue which I've thrown away, so there's the tiniest amount of super glue on there, and then put the card in. That's done the job. That's actually held it really, really well. I've done my weathering effects. If you watch to the end of this video, I will actually tag on the end how I did my chipping effects. I did it the same as I do for my normal drop pods that I've done, which is basically using the sponge technique. So there's like the normal drop pod that I do and done. You can see the kind of chipping effects there. It says, there you go, you can see some of the. So yeah, there's a quick tutorial at the end of this vid if you want to hold on, which shows you how I did the chipping effects and how I go about it. All the doors are magnetised in the up position at the moment, which I'll bring them down in a second, but I did the chipping effects. Soot effects is basically model air black. Basically I start at the bottom and I feather it in as I go up. So it's not so dark up here and obviously lighter at the bottom. This also helps create, which you would have, areas like this. You can see in there, it's got this light green at the bottom because that's where like the carbon wouldn't be able to get into so easily. It collects beneath and on that side, as it were. So this, as it should be, as it's travelling down. And then one of the tricks I do is I put dust effects on top of the soot, because obviously the soot's put on as it's going through the atmosphere and its final act is to plow itself into the ground, so all these dust effects is like the actual earth and dust and all that lot that's been thrown up. So let's open it up. I'll just spin it around as I do that, so you can see it's like the actual effects here, how they've come out, the chipping effects. I've kind of tried to put it one side more than the other because obviously as it's travelling through the atmosphere it's not going straight down, it's also turning, so it came out really well. So there we go. What I did in the inside, cleaned up some of the bolt gun or steel that was in here. I redid these lines. Let me see if I can move the camera a bit. There we go. I redid these lines and then rewashed them, and then that's when the chipping effects has come in. Really does come out quite well. And then I've done on these quick lighting effects, so it's a dark blue and then go in very finely using the light blue. So it's very, yeah, not the camera doesn't help, sorry about that guys, I do apologise. So it's actually quite a simple kit really, in the sense that it's not a lot to paint, hence the big space for the big dread. So there we go. Thank you very much, Templar Crusade, or Brian. Very good guy. I met him at Warhammer World, Forge World's Open Day, which was really good. Let me see if I can zoom in a bit on the chipping effects. So you can see the subtle way that the chipping effects works. And it's very easy, very quick, sponge technique. You may have seen it on other people's channels. Like I say, if you hold on, you will see it on the end of this video. So this is for my pre-heresy army, and I should be using it in the next game. Dropping my Contemptor Dreadnought in with Power Fist, Heavy Flamer and a Keras Pattern Assault Cannon. So now my opponent knows exactly what I'm going to be doing. please comment, rate and subscribe. Hang on if you want to see the tutorial. And I'll catch you in the next one. Take care. Okay guys, last time I did a drop pod vid, I was actually asked to show what I called the sponge technique. And this is a new drop pod that I'm doing. Bit of a refurbishment and basically quick paint up job. Now this drop pod is the Lucius Dreadnought pattern, and they have a few weaknesses on the hinges down here, so I'll explain that in the normal video when I'm showing this off. What I'm actually to do is a sponge technique, which is basically a chipping effect that can put down all the main crack areas. And the idea is to heavily weather this thing. So first thing I do, get a general paint, get this kind of more like rain effect and stuff on it, where residues build up. Then I go for a chipping effect. Once I've finished the chipping effect, I will then do a soot effect, which is basically using the airbrush for black, and just bring it up, generalizing and holding more black at the bottom. And then I actually do dust, because obviously it's gone through the atmosphere, little things have pinged off it, the paint's flaked off, all the carbon's built up, which is the soot. And then its final act is to throw itself into the ground, into the dust. So the dust is then kicked up and thrown up, so it gets a light coating of what I use for the dust effects at the bottom. So yes, there's quite a lot for me to do. So I'll just I'll go ahead and show you the tools that I use. A sponge. This one is from a KR case. It's just like any normal sponge. Quite soft, which is good because it'll protect the figures. Yeah, squidgy. A little palette, which at the moment I've got hundreds of these, and I don't use them anymore. Pretty much no one else uses them anymore because we can move data a lot better. And then the paint, which in this case is Game Colours Gunmetal Metal. I've had this for a while, and I only use it for this type of project. Don't really paint with it that often. I use it mainly for chipping effects of this nature. And it's only the drop pods that I do this on. So let me just squeeze a little bit out onto my palette. Let me move the camera down a little bit. That's a lot. So let me just tilt the camera down. He says, that's my palette. And that's my little bit that's actually a lot. Take the sponge, and I'm going to use this edge to dip with for a while. After a while, what will happen is the paint will dry. And it goes all hard, you don't really get the effect you want. So, switch sides, you've got quite a few of them. Once that's done, I tend to fold. Use that, and yes, it gets messy. So, here we go. So we start off a little bit on the bottom, try and spread it out, and dab, just get rid of the excess, but like you would with dry brushing. I've now got that, and then we just go in. What I'm trying to do is concentrate on the edges more than anything else, so I'm just going straight up the edge there, straight there, across there like that. And then I help people do this all the time, having a camera in the face, when I'd like to get up close and personal to the model so I can make the best effect. I don't know. Makes me appreciate them a little bit more. So across there we go. So quite quickly, I've done most of this panel already. I've done the upper section, I'll move that out of the way. I'll show you. You can see the kind of, it's a worn effect. It says too much light, direct light, it's not helping actually. So I'm going to do indirect lighting. So you can see, I hope you can make out the effect. And you see how it's reflecting. He says. So there. It's quite a simple little effect. I've got to pull the door down. I've got to do all down these sides. Do the actual wings as well. But I only do the outside. I only do this like that. And then first. And then the sutting effects. This has to go on first really, because the soot will build up even on the chip, paint chips. So you've got to do this before you do the soot effects. I will be doing on the inside of this thing, he says. These models are notorious for bad hinges. So yeah, I've got all inside here to do and all that. And then I will at the end do some lighting effects on these, which is basically a darkish blue and then a light blue. But very subtle, don't want it overpowering. Hopefully you'll like this, it'll be useful to you. Please comment, rate and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.